Okay, so moving on to UVs. So we've covered this a few times, so this is going to be pretty quick. So this object here, it's perfectly symmetrical. So what I want to drop on is just a mirror modifier, so I only have to do one side, using the bisect, and making sure that we can kind of see what it's doing in edit mode. So what I'm going to do here is, so first off, I know I just want to pull all of this bottom stuff off. So I'm just selecting these faces, bringing my cursor over here, hitting U to unwrap them, and then doing an H in this window just to hide them and get them out of my way. Next up, I'm moving over to edge mode. And for the most part, I use a lot of holding down the control, as it just basically kind of connects your lineup for you. That's a good one there. So we want to mark that seam. And then we want to cut this thing down the inside. And so remember too, as we're working away with this, the delete or period on your numpad, it allows you to not only zoom in on what we have selected, but it also makes that the new camera center. So it just makes it easier to work on. You start to get things that are going to be more and more complex. It's going to be harder to really isolate and take a look at where you want to go. So, and also with the control, I've got this one selected. I hold down control and hit this one. And it basically just tries to find the shortest route. And that's all the way down to here. So we're going to mark that seam. Mark this seam. Let's go with this one. Okay. So remember too, as you're doing the UVs, you're not always going to get it on the first try, and so you want to see it how far, how much you can kind of get away with. So I'm just going to actually take going into polygon mode. So when I hit L, it doesn't grab the whole object, it grabs just right up until it runs into a seam, and then hitting U to see what we're looking at. And we can tell right away that this piece of leg and this piece of leg should be relatively the same, and it's not even close, and we can definitely see where the issue is right in here. So we know that we got to make this cut in here somewhere. So I'm gonna go with straight across here, I guess. Do something like that. Mark seam. Polygon mode L. Oops. I didn't cut it all the way around. So go back down here, grab that one, mark seam. Polygon mode L. So we do a U on this one. There we go. So that's looking a hell of a lot better. And depending on what it is I'm shooting for detail, because I can kind of go one of two ways with this top portion here, because we're seeing that it is actually kind of stretching out into a trapezoid shape where it should be actually almost a perfect rectangle. So on this one, I'm going to make the judgment call that I would rather have this look nice and not stretched out, and live with the fact that I'm going to get some seams here and here. So I'm just going into edge mode, grabbing that seam and this seam. Remember, we can only right click and mark seam in this window. So make the selection here, move over, mark seam. Polygon mode again, L and U. And now we're looking at something like this, where we got no stretching there, and these are nice and open back up. And that should leave this one also ready to pop open and look nice, as it does. Good. We got this leg done, and we have it currently selected, hitting H to hide it. And then knowing that we're going to do the exact same thing here. So edge mode, hitting the delete key to zero in on it, grabbing that, opening these up, and then, oops, going polygon mode so it doesn't select the whole object, grab that and that, U to unwrap, and H. And let's see here. Cut it across here. Do the same over here. Mark those seams. Those seams, mark these seams. There we go. And so with all those marked, I'm not going to bother and unwrap them until I actually apply the mirror modifier. So what I want to do, Alt H, bring everything back and get out of edit mode and just apply that and get back into edit mode. So for this here, one thing that we need to do is go into our UV. And we're selecting seams from islands. And the reason we're doing that is because, remember early on, I grabbed these polygons and just ripped them off. So they actually didn't create a seam, so we can get it to just kind of build one for those. So now we see those are selected and wrapped around. Oh, shoot. And I probably should have unwrapped it because it actually got rid of those seams that I made, but it's not like it was rocket science what I did there. So let's just create those again. Mark that seam. And oops. Marking this seam. There we go. And so, theoretically, we should have enough cuts in this thing that the whole thing will just fly apart. Okay, and it did. Okay, so, one thing to check out here. The larger any shape is, the harder Blender, the harder the job Blender is going to have in trying to pack it quite nicely. And in all honesty, going into edge mode, grab this one. Dead center. Oh, actually, I forgot one other part to keep in mind as we're doing our mirror modifier. When you do apply it, it is going to throw this separation in. And since it wasn't there to begin with, we definitely don't need it now. So you just want to remember to go in there and get rid of that. Now with that cut, or sorry, with that one edge removed, if we take and remove that, mark seam, A to grab everything, and I just want to see how well it's going to do. Still not great. Actually, it's looking like, so if I go into poly mode, hit L. Okay. So somewhere in here, I messed up where these things are all still connected to each other, and it's right there. Oh, okay. I did it on one side and I didn't do it on the other. All right, done. So let's just back up a bit here. Before we make that cut, let's actually put these in. And now, polygon mode, grab everything, hit U. That is way better. Okay. So there. So if you do see some and they start to overlap like that, it might be that you just missed an edge somewhere. or what have you. So just keep an eye on that. And also, that packed quite nicely by default. So let's just skip over this one. So one thing to keep in mind. So we've been just kind of grabbing these things, hitting you, and going with it. Keep in mind that there's two methods, conformal and angle-based, and you will get significantly different results from each one. And depending on the shape, depending on how much hard surface, how curved surface it is, you're going to see sometimes it does it better one way than the other, but between the two of them, you should be able to find a decent hit. And two, you don't have to do everything the same way. So if, for instance, I don't know why, but say this one here doesn't look as well with that one. So if I hit U and tell it to go angle based, then I can get more of this shape if that's more what I need for the resolution and the coverage that I'm looking for. But I don't. So I'm going to grab everything and put it all back to conformal. And that's looking good. All right. That is a her.